Words of solidarity and support are wonderful and needed, but actions are better. This is a time of struggle and change for many communities, and even though this is a tech noodling YouTube channel, tech is not neutral, and this channel will never be neutral either. Links and resources for organizations working towards social justice and how you can actively participate will be in the description. The Arduino Uno was my first ever experience with electronics. A lot has changed since then, and Arduino actually just released a new board, the Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect. They sent it to me in this box with some stickers, 7 to be precise, so I can make some videos and projects with it. So let's take a quick tour of the board. It of course has the RP2040, which is essentially rookie of the year for electronics parts, a uBlox Nina W102 module that provides Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, 16 megabytes of flash, digital and analog I/O, micro USB, UART, SPI, I2C, an LSM6DSO-IMU for gyroscope and accelerometer action, a MEMS microphone, an ATEK 608A crypto coprocessor, not for cryptocurrency, but for cryptography, encryption, decryption, true random number generation, and secure boot. So 9 times out of 10, I program in Python. It's just what I prefer to do. But this is an Arduino board, so I think most folks would approach it with the Arduino IDE, coding in C. But it has the RP2040 processor. So I thought, basically as soon as it landed on my doorstep, could I port CircuitPython to it? And yeah, I did. It does the digital pins, I2C, onboard LED, onboard accelerometer, the internets, etc., etc. Huge shout out to the CircuitPython team for all of their assistance in the forms of answering questions on Discord and GitHub, excellent documentation that I was able to follow as a person doing this for the first time, and also edits to my PR that made Wi-Fi possible. Just an amazing community. Back to the board though. The Arduino website itself describes it as an Arduino with a Raspberry Pi filling, which I find to be a delightful description, because I think one of the age-old maker questions, and by that I mean maybe the past 10 plus years, has been should you use a Raspberry Pi or an Arduino for a project? As a result, this board definitely gives You've Got Chocolate in My Peanut Butter Reese's energy, but I love Reese's, so that's okay. I actually mailed a Reese's peanut butter cup in just a plain envelope to my friend at camp once. Didn't travel very well. I don't really recommend that. I was 12. All joking aside, I do want to mention though, I think as a community, saying Raspberry Pi has kind of become ubiquitous with the idea of a single board computer that runs Linux. And in the past few months, Raspberry Pi has come to mean that or the maker of the RP2040 processor that can be on a microcontroller to run Arduino, CircuitPython, or MicroPython, or even PIO assembly. And I worry people get confused with that. Like, it's kind of a change, you know? We've really had to kind of change our brains a bit to process that language a bit differently. So I want to mention that this is not a single board computer. This is a microcontroller. It does not run Linux, it runs discrete code. This could be its own video. I'm gonna move on now. Anyway, I've got plans for this board though, specifically as a Bluetooth remote for my Raspberry Pi streaming box so that I can really fully maximize the nomenclature confusion. More importantly, so that I can navigate my Raspberry Pi 4B single board computer so that I can stream hours of television and film. And I have been working on a GUI to make it more like a traditional streaming box app kind of thing that we think of today. So expect a follow-up on that shortly. But that's going to wrap up this overview of the Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect, a board in the Nano form factor with an RP2040 processor that connects to the internet. All seems to add up. I'll have some links and stuff down in the description, and until next time, this has been Blitz City DIY.